evening, gentlemen. I've got a lot of requests from people who want to know what's happening in Ukraine. Because the battle is now over 1 year old, and what is happening? Now, I'm going to give you a very different picture from what the Western press is telling you. First of all, if you go through what's happening, you will realize that Zelensky has played into the hands of the Americans, who are fighting a proxy war with Russia. And I wonder, and even other historians wonder, what has he gained out of it? Now, Ukraine has a population of about 40 million, and roughly 8 to 10 million people have run away from Ukraine, are refugees in Europe. That means almost 25% of the population has run away. And that includes a very productive part of the Ukrainian population as of women and children who grew up as the future of Ukraine. Another major point is that Ukraine is devastated. It was the granary of Europe, and now there is total devastation in Ukraine because the Russians are using the third and fourth generation weapons for which even the Americans have no answer at the moment. They recently dropped a 1,500 kg bomb on one of the cities in Ukraine. It was devastating. The Ukrainian infrastructure is destroyed. And coming down to Bakhmut, the city is almost in Russian hands. The Wagner group has claimed they have already captured the eastern part of the city. And yesterday, more than 200 Ukrainian soldiers were killed. Despite all the hullabaloo of the tanks coming from America, the tanks from Germany, they haven't made a difference in the war. Because now Putin has become ruthless. He was thinking of it as a limited military engagement. And perhaps if he had got his way at that time, the devastation would have been there. But when America propping up the Ukrainians, escalation was bound to happen, and now this is what has happened. So I don't know how people can say that Ukraine must keep on fighting. Fighting for what? And for whom are you fighting? You are fighting for the Americans in a proxy war, and you are destroying your own country. I think Zelensky is a novice in politics. And that is a very sad thing that such a man should be leading the Ukrainian nation. He's been confronted by a man who's an extremely strong man, though not in the mold of Joseph Stalin, but at the same time, he was better than the other Russian people who came before him, like Gorbachev and Yeltsin. And now he's got the weaponry. And if you have read the news, one of the Baltic states leaders has said that Russia can keep on fighting for another 2 years, and that country is an ally of the United States, is a member of NATO. Now, Bakhmut is almost in Russian hands, and once they capture it, the entire industrial region of the Donbas area will be open to them, and then they can have their drive towards Odisha. So, it's in the interest of Zelensky to get a ceasefire done, agree to the Russian terms to extend, negotiate for the good of Ukraine. If you are a leader and you love your people, I'm sure you will not like to wreak destruction on your own country like Samson brought down the temple of the heathens and killed himself in the Bible. So we must look for examples to the scriptures, and they show us the way. The scriptures, the Bible mentions the Armageddon, the last war. I wonder if Zelensky really realizes that this could be the beginning of that war. Now, what sort of leadership is he giving to a country where 25% of the population has run away and are refugees? There's no industry worth the name there, no agriculture, there's nothing. and all he's doing is to get some food and some weapons for America and keep on trying to fight the Russians and say, I'm going to throw the Russians out. Well, he hasn't been able to throw them out, and you know it, and I know it, he's not going to throw any Russian out. In fact, he's been losing land regularly. And the Ukrainians do not know how to intercept the latest Russian missiles, which are now hypersonic and are playing hell into the Ukrainian defenses. There's a lot of propaganda, you know. I was listening to Zelensky saying 1,100 soldiers have been killed, Russian soldiers, 10 depots destroyed. Wonderful. Even if it's true, it has got no meaning, because Zelensky is now on a leash. And the man holding the leash is Joe Biden and the Americans. Sometimes I wonder how a man can be so foolish, dominated by ego, that something like what Zulfikar Ali Bhutto did in Pakistan, and finally broke up Pakistan. And if you take an example, there are so many leaders like him who have destroyed their own countries for their own good. Hitler was one of them. He could have easily ended the war much earlier, and maybe he would have gained something. But he continued fighting till the end, till he had no choice and got himself, had to commit suicide, shot himself dead. Zelensky is not a man in shining armor. His name was mentioned in the Panama Papers, where he made investments in the Leeward Islands in London. And that sort of man is leading Ukraine. I don't think his family is in Ukraine. I think they are in London, if I am correct. And the Ukrainians are fighting on a false notion of patriotism. Patriotism for what? For the Americans? America is sitting back, Uncle Sam smoking a pipe, and Ukrainians dying like fodder, like meat being ground. Gentlemen, I thought I should speak on this matter to you, because the war is now at a very interesting stage. I think the Ukrainians would be reaching the end of the tether, and once Bakhmut falls entirely, it's going to be a different ball game. Gentlemen, the war in Ukraine is continuing, and I still maintain my view that in case there's no negotiated peace now and Zelensky doesn't say hands up, it's going to be complete destruction of Ukraine, and America doesn't know what is going to happen. If you remember the Red Indians in the old days, they used to have the signals coming through the smoke, and they used to blanket for it, and the smoke signals were being sent. He isn't reading the smoke signals which are coming from Ukraine. That the Ukrainians at the end of the tether, they are destroyed. I think Biden should see that. The people are in misery. They don't know what to do. And they are being egged on to fight. For what? I think the only course is the removal of Mr. Zelensky. Maybe that would be better. Otherwise, he has to change his tune, negotiate with the Russians, and try and salvage the situation. Otherwise, I'm afraid Ukraine will be completely destroyed. And not only that, Ukraine is going to lose a lot of its independence. I close now, gentlemen. I hope you like this video. It's a short one. Share it with your friends. Subscribe to my channel. And I hope you do it. And I'll close now and say, Jai Hind, glory to India. Take care and enjoy yourself. And don't go to Ukraine. God bless.